What's a genius? Now, LeFou, I want you to go out into the woods and bring me back the biggest, healthiest deer you can find.
Not the woods. Anything but the woods. You know I hate the woods.
Just get me a deer for my wedding feast.
But I hate the woods. It's dark and spooky, and it's filled with bugs and spiders.
Papa, are you all right?
I'm fine. But I can't for the life of me figure out why that happened. If it isn't the stubbornest piece of...
Papa!
I'm about ready to give up on this hunk of junk.
Oh, you always say that.
I mean it this time. I'll never get this boneheaded contraption to work.
Yes, you will. And you win first prize at the fair tomorrow. Huh. And become a world-famous inventor.
You really think so?
You know I do. I always have.
Well, we'd better get cracking. This thing's not going to fix itself. Now let me see, where did I put that dog-legged clencher?
Papa.
So tell me, did you have a good time in town today?
I got a new book.
Oh, you do love those books.
Well, they take me away to wonderful places where there's adventure and mystery and romance and happy endings. Papa, if I ask you something, will you answer me? Honestly?
Don't I always?
Do you think I'm odd?
Odd? My daughter odd? Now where would you get an idea like that?
I don't know. It's just that, well, people talk.
They talk about me too. No, I'm not odd nor you. No family could be saner, except for an uncle who, well, maybe let that pass. In all you say or do, you couldn't make it plainer. You are your mother's daughter, therefore you are class.
So I should just accept I'm simply not like them.
They are the common herd, and you can take my word. You are unique, creme de la creme. No matter what you do, I'm by your side. And if my point of view is somewhat misty-eyed, there's nothing clearer in my life than what I wish and feel for you. And that's a lot, no matter what.
No matter what they say, you make me proud. Love the funny way you stand out from the crowd.
It's my intention, my invention, show the world out there one day just what we've got.
No matter what.
Now some may say all fathers just exaggerate.
That every daughter's great.
You are. No matter what the pain, we've come this far. I pray that you remain exactly as you are. This really is a case of father knowing best.
And daughter too.
You're never strange.
Don't ever change.
You're
alive.
Out of this town and go to all
all those places you've read about in your books. Well, I'm off.
Bye, Papa.
Bye-bye, Belle.
Be careful.
First prize is nearly mine. It's quite my best invention. So simple yet complex, so massive yet so small. This triumph of design will be my old age pension. That is, providing I can find the fair at all. I must have missed a sign. I should have paid attention. That's not a nightingale, and not the mating call.
Wolves! Stay back! Him in.
We could not leave him for the wolves.
Is anyone home?
If we keep quiet, maybe he'll go away.
Someone here?
Not a word, Lumiere. Not one word.
I don't mean to intrude, but I've lost my way in the woods, and I need a place to stay for the night.
Oh, poor fellow. Oh, Cogsworth, have a howl. Monsieur, you're welcome here.
I heard that. I know there's someone here. And I'll thank for you to step out where I can see you.
Hello!
And goodbye.
Wait. You're a clock. And you're talking.
Astonishing, isn't it? And quite inexplicable. Goodbye.
Cogsworth, I'm surprised at you. Where are your manners?
You know what the master will do if he finds out we let a stranger into the castle.
This is incredible. How is this accomplished?
Really, sir, if you just... Ah! Stop it! Stop it, I say!
Well, I'm stumped. Maybe it's some kind of newfangled scientific gadget.
I, sir, am not a gadget.
I beg your pardon. I don't mean to be rude. It's just that I've never seen a talking.
Bless you.
Oh, you are chilled to the bone, monsieur. Come, warm yourself by the fire.
Oh, no. I forbid it. Lumiere, as head of this household, I demand that you stop right there. Oh, no, not the master's chair. I'm not seeing this.
Oh, la la, what have we here? Do my eyes deceive me, or is this a man? It's been so long since I've seen a real man. No offense, Lumiere. Bonjour, monsieur. Mind if I sit here?
All right, this has gone far enough. I am in charge here, and I will not allow this
coming
kind of behavior
through.
To...
How would you like a nice spot of tea, sire? It will warm you up in no time.
Oh, yes, please.
Oh, no. No tea. He will be here all night, Mrs. Potts. No tea.
There you are.
Oh, this is just what I needed.
I think I scared him, Mama.
Hey there, little fella. What's your name?
Chip.
Figures.
Care for a blanket, monsieur? I just love older men.
Ah, Babette, you are always trying to make me jealous. Well, it's not going to work this time.
Me? What about you? With Simone?
Pierre?
Michel?
Jack?
Veronique?
Oh, Veronique.
Lumiere, listen to me. We've got to get him out of here. Do you know what the master will do if he finds out we let a stranger in?
Calm yourself, Cogsworth. The master will never have to know. As I was saying, he's bound to find out sooner or later.
Should we hide, Mama?
No. Remain calm. There's absolutely no reason to panic.
Lumiere is right. There's absolutely no reason to panic. May I borrow this?
There's a stranger here.
Master, allow me to explain. The gentleman was sent upon by one...
Who let him in?
Master, may I take this opportunity to say that I was against this from
who
the start?
Who dared to disobey?
Oh, dear.
You have all betrayed me. Who are you,
Maurice?
What are you doing in my castle?
I lost my way in the woods.
You're not welcome here!
I know. I'll just be on my way.
It's hideous, isn't it?
Oh, no, I wasn't.
You've came to stare at the beast, haven't you?
No, I was merely looking for a place to stay.
I'll give you a place to stay!